The back door and Elektra Records would like to welcome you to Montezuma Hall. Please welcome Mickey Newbury.
The guy sitting right about out there, you left the seeds in this stuff, man. Got a distinct seed smell. Doggone my soul, how I love them old songs. They were a comfort to me when I was alone. Dancing stops, but the music goes on. Doggone my soul, I love them old songs. Ah, when I hear that double eagle guitar, it makes me think how trouble-free girl we are. There was a time I spent my time in a bar. Songs. Well, it take me back to hardwood floors, outdoor jars and mason jars. It's all I can do to believe that it's gone, that hard knocking, rock and rolling life that I've known. But the dancing's all over, the music must go on. Doggone my soul. Sip some brew with my good friend Maggie the Bohemian. Lord, she's quite a woman of the world. I'm the envy of the men. Heaven help the child. Heaven help the child. Paris in the 20s, quiet can offer plenty to a young man with a vision, so they say. With a friend named Fitzgerald, I'm headed for the old world on a merchant steamer bound for Biscay Bay. Heaven help the child. Heaven help the child. Take him back to where he's never been. We're all building walls, they should be bridges. We're all building walls, they should be bridges. To the city.
pick another sad song for me, Jim. I hate to leave the old man all alone to work the cotton, but the country never seems to bother him. I said to the general as we made the battle plans out for the day, this would be the last one. Only God be willing, we can go back home this time to stay.
It's not going over it live, is it? Oh, God Almighty. I want to do a song for you. If I can. My wife, when I first met her, was with the Christian Minstrels. And there was another girl in the group by the name of Monica, lived in Los Angeles. And she was a big Edgar Casey fan, read everything he had. And every time there'd be a newspaper article that come out talking about an earthquake, it just terrified her. So this one particular year, I think it was 67, they pinpointed the date that Los Angeles was supposed to fall off into the ocean. And the guy says, you know, it's some geologist, and he said, this is when it's going to happen. It's going to fall off in the ocean on exactly July the 4th at 10 p.m. So she was so scared that she jumped a plane and went to Mexico City to get away from it. And July the 4th rolled around, and there wasn't an earthquake. So she decided that since she was already so close, she'd just go to Acapulco and celebrate the occasion. And the day she got there, they had the first earthquake they'd ever had in Acapulco in about 150 years. So this is a song that, this is for Monica. On his mountain, Lord, there sits a long gray bearded ancient hermit, sadly staring at the caption in the San Mateo Times. It reads, today the prophets all agreed that California was to be swallowed in the twinkling of an eye. He goes thumbing through his growing stack of half unfinished rhyme till he finds the one he'd once submitted to the New York Times. Lord, they laughed at him and said, "You senile, wine old drunk old fool, get out of here. You must have lost your mind." So he went back to his mountain, Lord, where he began to pray. He prayed for those in ignorance that would treat a man that way. Ah, the truth will fall like a mountain, Lord, on all that have grown deaf. The day the world is swallowed up and California's left.
Excuse me.
Yeah. I always did get a dry mouth when I got a good whiff of that stuff. Oh, man, in Nashville, where I've lived for about the last 10 years, up until about 4 years ago, there was an old man there that I used to go down and listen to all the time. He sold paper bags down on Commerce Street. He was a blind man. He played guitar and was really a great old guy, you know. And he won a Grammy, believe it or not. A few years ago, RCA Victor went out on the street and with a tape recorder and taped him while he was out there and submitted the recording to the section that deals with authentic folk songs, and he got the Grammy that year for it. Didn't mean much to him as far as his pocketbook, but in fact, it really didn't mean much to him at all. He really didn't even know what it was. Cortelia couldn't see it anyway, so. So I was in San Francisco playing at the boarding house 1 week, and when I got back home, picked up all the newspapers and went inside, started reading through them, and found out that he had burned to death in his trailer while I was gone. So, don't know how much it'll mean ever to him, but this is a song that I wrote about him. I was just a boy the year the Bluebird Special came through here on its first run south to New Orleans. A blind old man and I, we came to Guthrie just to see the train. He was black and I was green. "Tell me what you see," he said. "Is the engine black or red, son?" "Why, that's the loudest thing I've ever seen." Then he picked his guitar up, sat on the fender of the truck, and his eyes lit up as he began to sing. And I remember when that old man's dreams were changed down in Guthrie, and the Bluebird special train. He picked his guitar up, shuffled down the walk, the cars uptown wound round the buildings at his feet. Looking mighty proud, that old man, with his battered hat in his hand. 'Cause Lord, he sung a song that made me weep. Yes, he made me weep. I read it in a week old paper that no one made it for his wake, or laid a flower at his feet. He was just a blind old beggar, people said. Lord, I wager he ain't begging up there on your streets. You'll find him, Lord, this morning. Save a street in glory, Lord, for Cortelia Clark. I was just a boy the year the Bluebird special came through here on its first run south to New Orleans. A blind old man and I, we came to Guthrie just to see the train. He was black and was I green.
Sang a song along with the wind.
There's so many things I don't believe we'll understand. Why the days turn into weeks, turn into months. Years become a moment in the ever-changing sand. Did God make time to keep it all from happening at once, all at once? I came to face the music. Close your eyes and let the sky fall softly down all around the light. Let yourself be swept into the silent, ever-healing arms of the night. Save these precious moments for the child behind your eyes, to touch the things he lost along the way. 'Cause I believe that in his wisdom, God has set aside this time to let us all go home to yesterday. Sky falls softly down all around the night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, his daddy was an honest man, just a red dirt Georgia farmer. Mama lived a short life, having kids and baling hay. He had 15 years and an aching sight to wander, so he hopped a freight and way cross, wound up in L.A. Lord, the cold nights had no pity on that way cross Georgia farm boy. Most days he went hungry, then the summer came. He met a girl known on the strip as San Francisco's Mabel Joy, destitution's child, born of an L.A. street called shame. Growing up came quietly in the arms of Mabel Joy. Laughter found their mornings
brought a meaning to his life. And on the night before she left, sleep came and left that way cross-country boy with dreams of Georgia cotton and a California wife. Sunday morning found him standing 'neath the red light at her door. When a right cross set him reeling, put him face down on the floor. In place of Mabel Joy, he found a merchant mad marine who growled, "Your Georgia neck is red, but sonny, you're still green." So he turned 21 in a Gray Rock federal prison. The old judge had no mercy on that Waycross Georgia boy. Staring at those four gray walls in silence, Lord, he listened to that midnight freight he knew take him back to Mabel Joy. Sunday morning found him lying 'neath the red light at her door. With a bullet in his side, he cried, "Have you seen Mabel Joy?" Stunned and shaken, someone said, "Son, she don't live here no more. No, she left this house 4 years today. They say she's looking for some Georgia farm boy." My folks live just outside of Houston. I don't know whether anybody here from Houston? No. San Antonio. Yeah, ever heard of the Big Thicket? Well, they're gonna make a national forest out of it because nobody will live in it, so except my folks. They live just about 40 miles outside of Houston, and there's a lot of funny people down there, you know. They're good people, but some real characters. And this one song I'm going to sing to you right here is one I wrote about a friend of my dad's named Booger Red. Every town's got a Booger Red, I swear. Oh, I'll tell you a funny story. Have we got time to tell a funny story? Booger's goes hunting all the time, and he's got about 10 or 12 squirrel dogs that he just You know, every time he goes out and gets in his truck, and they just run to the truck and jump in the back of the truck. If he has to be going to the store, then they miss out, you know. But they always in the truck. And he's always talking about how disciplined they are, you know. He said, you know, he can stop off the side of the road and they'll all jump out and go out in the woods and they'll tree a squirrel and he'll shoot it and that's it, you know. He says he can get a squirrel every day he wants one. And he's always bragging about how disciplined they were, you know. Well, we're going to get into a longer story. I'll make a long story short. Used to, when I was traveling around all the time, I had this old car. I won't go into it, but the battery kept going down, and I had to stop over the side of the road because the fan belt was slipping and kill the heater, you know, or kill the lights. I couldn't run the lights and the heater at the same time. So I'd have to pull over the side of the road, kill the lights, wait till the car got real hot, and then turn the lights on and drive until it started chugging and kill the heater and then wait till I got so cold I had to pull off the side of the road anyway. So in my, what this did was that I couldn't even stop to get a cup of coffee because if I did, you know, I had to get somebody to come out and jump the cables, you know, so jump the batteries. So I'm outside of a little town out of Monroe, Louisiana one night, and I'm waiting for the car to warm up, you know. So I jump out of the car, and I'm running around the car trying to keep warm while it's warming up. And a dog barked, you know. Well, stupid as it sounds, you know, at 3 o'clock in the morning when you've been up for about 15 hours, you know, I turn and I barked back at him. And by the time I left there, there were dogs barking for about 50 miles, you know. It was because it just started a chain reaction. Well, anyway, I got to where I'd do that for kicks when I'd be bored, you know, and I'd be trying to keep awake. I'd pull off a side of the road in, like, Pine Bluff, Arkansas, and when they'd roll the town up, right in the middle of town, start barking. When I'd leave there, everybody'd be awake, you know. I said, hell, if I got to be awake, they have to, too, you know. So one day, Booger comes to the house, and squirrel dogs, if one of them barks off in the woods, then all the rest of them would go to the same tree and bark, you know. And that's, I guess, I don't know what the reason why, but that's the way they do it, you know. So Booger pulls up in the yard and he starts in the house and I went, whoa! Well, the dogs all jumped out of the truck and ran to the nearest tree. So. So you can imagine Booger, he's really rattled because, you know, when he gets out of the truck, he says, stay, and they always stay, you know. But here I barked, and they all run to a tree. So he said, what's going on? I said, well, I told the dogs there was a squirrel in the tree. So to this day, Booger thinks that I'm able to talk to those dogs. He's almost got in about a half dozen fights over it, you know, because that's even a little bit tall for Texas. But anyway, here a while back, Booger's wife left him. And she, well, I'll. Lord, them got no nothings got me down, down, down. My two-time flushing mama's Memphis bound, Memphis bound. With some good time, Charlie, Lord, my truck and my best hound. She left me with 10 acres of grown-up Georgia ground. I got them come home lately's, go to bed early's, cussing, crying, kicking, moan. Since she been gone, I got them come home lately's, go to bed early's. Good God, I miss that dog since they've been gone. Might get up and go, got up and gone, gone, gone. Lord, they took my pickup truck, ain't done me wrong. If I could lay my calloused hands on them three thieving clowns, well, I'd sure plant me something in this burned up Georgia ground. I got them come home lately's, go to bed early's, cussing, crying, kicking home. Since she been gone, I got them come home lately's, go to bed early's. Good God, I miss my truck. Well, she didn't really steal this dog. You see, that was the fastest one in the pack. He just happened to make it to the truck right before she got away, you know? Morning came and found her at the window with her nose pressed to the glass. Lord, the dew was like a broken diamond necklace left scattered on the grass. She slipped from my side. She stands at the window and watches the rain. God, I wish I was blind and could not read her mind and see all her pain. But from here where I lie, I can see the tears as she quietly cries out for him, not for me. How many times must the piper be paid for a song? Her shattered dreams, they're like broken glass cutting through to her soul. Leaving her naked mind alone now to tremble and cry. Any day now she knows that he'll call. Lord, she's wondering if I'll be around when he's gone and she's left to fall. How many times must the piper be paid for a song? Well, the sun fell through the window. Lord, the morning was filled with the singing. Will she ever remember he sung the songs but forgot all the words? Yes, from here where I lie, I can see all the tears in her eyes as she quietly cries. Then she turns and she walks back to me. How many times must the piper be paid for a song?
Thank you. times they're not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Oh, I wish I was in Dixie, away, away in Dixieland. I'll take my stand to live and die in Dixie. Dixieland, you're where I was born. Early, Lord, one frosty morning. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Glory, glory, hallelujah.
What do you do when you close with your big number? Which one? Oh, okay. Anyway, this song was written by a really good friend of mine down in Bossier City, Louisiana, named Percy Mayfield. He, anybody know Percy Mayfield? He wrote Hit the Road Jack and a lot of songs for Ray Charles. Got me thrown out of Bowie City, Louisiana, by the Ku Klux Klan, among other things. But this is really a fine old song of his, and I know a lot of people have never heard it. I just hope I can do it justice. I hadn't played it in so many years. Heaven please send to all mankind some understanding and peace of mind. But if it's not asking too much, won't you please send me someone to love? I'd show the world how to get along. Peace will enter where hate has gone. But if it's not asking too much, won't you please send me someone to love? I lay awake at night, I see the world so troubled, and my answer's still the same. Lest man don't put an end to his terrible, terrible sins, well, hate's gonna put the world in a flame. And what a shame, just because I'm in misery. Well, I don't beg for no sympathy. But if it's not asking too much, won't you please send me someone to love? This is one of the first big country records that I had recorded by Jerry Lee Lewis. He's about a half crazy man sometimes. He calls himself the killer. Sometimes I think he is. But he was the first one. In fact, he was one of the first ones to ever cut anything I wrote. First time I moved to Nashville, I didn't know what was really going on. I got down there, it was 10 years ago. And I was writing all kinds of different things. Really it just depended on where I was. If I happened to be in Memphis, I'd be trying to write rhythm and blues. And if I was down in Texas, I was trying to write country. And one night I was in hell and tried to write a psychedelic song. And It was a song called "Just Dropped In to See What Condition My Condition Was In," and I took it into my publisher, which publishes all Hank Williams songs, and he just kind of looked at me real funny and said, "Well, I don't think I can do much of that." So Jerry Lee Lewis was the only one who had any guts to cut it. He cut it, and it stayed around in a can for about 5 years, and finally Kenny Rogers cut it. I'm not going to do that one for you because I hadn't got a Leslie with me. But what was I saying? Oh, yeah. So this is a song that Jerry Lee Lewis cut for me. He really did a fine job on. Well, morning's come. Lord, my mind is aching. Sunshine's standing quietly at my door. Just like the dawn, my heart is silently breaking. With my tears it goes tumbling to the floor. Once again the old town we'll be talking. Lord, I've seen the pity that's in their eyes. They could never understand. It's her sorrow, it's not a man. Well, no matter what they say, I know she tried. Baby's packed her soft things and she's left me. But I just know she never meant to make me cry. It's not her heart, Lord, it's her mind. She didn't mean to be unkind. Why she even woke me up to say goodbye.
God bless you. Thank you. Thank you so much.